Like, we up here killing LaFleur and Sala saying, who the hell calls a sneak on fourth and two?
That's the
and
dumbest call.
Bart kiddingly said, what if the kid calls on number? I was like, there's no way.
We both there's said no way. Way. We was like, no way, way you do that.
What? So for you to call your own number on fourth and two with Willie, three defensive tackles.
Bro, you
over no, three, the two guards.
Three of the greatest defensive tackles.
One of three of the best run stoppers in the league. Like, that's not a look you sneak it. You only sneak it if it's a look. And then it's fourth and two. You're not getting 2 yards on that. Like, that is unexcusable. And he honestly needs to apologize to all his teammates right now.
We've all prepared for a game, right? We've all prepared for a Sunday game. The quarterback, we know the relationship from an OC to quarterback, right? If there's two people on the team who's most connected as far as what I need to think for Sunday and what you need to think, they're connected. They're one and one, right? So this whole narrative, like, well, it needs to be communicated. No. Zach knew what he should have done in that moment.
100%.
Hand the ball off. He didn't need LaFleur to say that to him. He didn't need anybody to say that to him. You've watched your main man, Braxton Get Down Berrios, from University of Miami, have one of the best games of his career today. It's fourth and two. You're going toe-to-toe with Tampa Bay Brady's
Super Bowl champ,
the GOAT. You have a chance to put MetLife in an absolute state of glee. Hand the ball off. You have Vita Vader, Sue, and Steve McClendon. By the way, when Steve McClendon was here, he was the number one run stopper for the New York Jets. This is not about looking at looks. This is about saying to myself, it's my time to be the guy. I'm going to win the game, and everybody's going to love me. This was about ego. This is about selfishness. This is about not understanding that at this point in the game, it's not about Zach Wilson. This is about the New York Jets.
Before, we were talking about he needed to humble himself because he was trying to make it about himself and prove how big his arm was, and I talked about it before the game. Like, being a great player is doing the little things, you know, routinely. And the little thing would be to hand the ball off and let Berrios live in the day and be the guy. But he wanted to go with the quarterback sneak so he can get up and pump his fists. Look what I just did. I won the game and do all that type of stuff. Me. Instead of allowing Berrios to be able to be the guy to get the reverse, make the first down so y'all can take the knee and you can say you beat the GOAT. See, so that's the character flaw. We're not talking about, you know, who cares in the grand scheme of whether they win this game or lose this game. It wasn't about that. It's about the decision-making of the guy that's going to have the ball in his hands more than anybody on the field, because he has your future in his hands literally 80 times a game. That's why he's considered the most important person on the field. It's because it's his decision and his ability to be a high-percentage decision-maker to do that.